yes, please. Come in. Yes, please do. Take a seat, feel free. Make yourself as comfortable as you would like. Yes, excellent. Well, welcome to my little abode, my little nook, my mark on the world, if you will. This is my little independent bookshop, preserve the greatest pieces of our time, but also accommodate a more mass popular market. We specialize in all sorts. What are you looking for today? Books, I do presume. Yes. Okay. So you're not looking for anything old. You're looking for modern. Yes, no, that is perfect. We can accommodate. Okay, can I ask you, what do you prefer? Do you prefer fiction, the world of make-believe, or non-fiction, reality, cold hard facts, knowledge at its core? You prefer a bit of both? Excellent, no, we can definitely accommodate that. So, in terms of fiction, what do you enjoy? Do you enjoy fantasy? Do you enjoy apocalyptic scenarios? You enjoy a bit of both. Okay, so if I just look over here and see what I can find in that regard. Okay, so we'll first check this out. You're a fan of paperback, yeah? Perfect. So, here I have a new book recently got in. It is fantasy, so it should be Radical Street. It's also based on a hit video game. Are you a fan of video games? Do you engage with the medium? No. Well, you do a bit. Yeah, perfect. You used to play when you were younger. Perfect. I may have something for you a bit later then. But we'll leave it till then. This book is called Blood of Elves, and it is by the Polish author Andrzej Sapkowski. Now, what Sapkowski does is he creates the world of The Witcher. The Witcher is this mystical humanoid who has extreme human abilities far beyond what normal humans can reach. And in this world, The Witcher, who the main protagonist is called Geralt, must go and find various beasts. Crazy beasts. And there's elves, there are humans, there are monsters so dark and so twisted, it is truly an adventure. And he also has friends. Dandelion, a bard, Ciri, a close friend, and Yennefer, a love interest. The Blood of Elves will take you and it will definitely keep you engaged from the first page to the last page. We are currently retailing this at £8.99, and if you are interested, we will have other books in the series which we can check out at a later date, or if you go away and enjoy the book, you can feel free to come back and check it out. Would that be something you're interested in? Maybe. No problem, we'll put it on the maybe pile, and if you are interested, we can always check it out later. The next things I have for you, they're not novels in the strictest sense of the word. They're definitely books, and they convey a rich world. You may have heard of the series. Have you heard of The Walking Dead? as beautiful sort of drawn artwork, all in black and white. And it tells of the police officer Rick Grimes, who is awoken into an apocalypse. Zombies have taken over the world. And The Walking Dead follows Rick as he finds his family, engages in a community, and finds himself becoming a leader, a position he doesn't necessarily want. And what The Walking Dead does so well is the emphasis is less on the zombies themselves, but on the people, on human interactions with one another in this apocalyptic scenario. And the great thing about book one is it really does gets you involved with the story. What I found when I was reading the individual issues of the comics, you'd get to the end of it and you'd have to wait for the next one, and you'd be like, oh, I really just want keep on reading. So yes, would you be interested? Hold on. If you pick this up, it's currently retailing at £20. If you pick this up, what we can throw in for free. Some various issues of comics. This is the Walking Dead issues 121 to 125. Very easy to just jump in, and it tells of the mini series All Out War. Now All Out War is a really great story arc, and Rick certainly develops as the character. I won't spoil it too much for you. What is great is that these comics cannot hold it forever. coffee table book. They could just pick up and put down. Yeah. Tell you what, we can do that for £15 if you'd be interested. Yeah, okay, no problem. Just put that over there for you. Excellent to hear. Now, you mentioned you are also interested in non-fiction, more sort of real world. Would you say you're more science-rooted, interested in a scientific path? Or would you say you're interested more by, let's say, sort of like business, economics, etc., stuff like that? The latter. Yeah. Perfect. Well, I've got a pretty awesome business biography that has just came in. It's called The Everything Store, and it is written by Brad Stone, and it's basically an in-depth sort of history of the company Amazon.com. You've probably heard of them. They are undercutting me every day, but we will not get into that. And it goes into the history of Jeff Bezos, the CEO and founder of Amazon. And what's so interesting about it is you learn, you start to understand Bezos as a character, his motivations, how his mind works. And it takes you from the grassroots of the business when they were selling in their garage, you know, boarding themselves, you know, rushing off to the post office to get deliveries out, down. The business developed online. It took the online retailing world by storm, and how it currently has such a huge market share, but also how it expanded from books to DVDs to music to entertainment to is now a huge conglomerate. And it's also quite long, and it also contains pictures in full colour of Bezos and the company. It truly is. It was a winner of the Financial Times and Goldman Sachs Business Book of the Year. And it truly is written very entertainingly. It's not dry. There's a great pace to it. That'd be something you're interested in. Yeah. No, that's cool. It's great. Really do like business biographies. We're actually ordering a few more in. There's one. There's a book that's came out called Creativity Inc. And that very similarly, that looks at Pixar. Obviously, the company that makes such great animated films. So what we could do, we can let you know when that comes in. Sure. Okay, so the last book I have to show you is very much a very intriguing and interesting book. The book's called Super Forecasting. You're probably thinking, what is super forecasting? Well, it is the art and science of prediction. And this book has been almost sort of like, it's been 20 years of research, and the Professor Philip Tetlock and Dan Gardner, they go into a study in showing how there are some people who have sort of real foresight, and they look at how these people are able to predict, you know, they can predict the future with a degree of accuracy to 60% greater than average. And so this book sort of like delves into sort of like the hows and the whys of how you can predict, you can have a better chance at prediction. You know, there are no guarantees, but this book is so engrossing, you truly are intrigued from page to end. I'm reading it at the moment. I'm about halfway through, and it really is. They use so many great real world examples to help demonstrate points and to explore different themes further. It truly is a book that gets the mind going. listening to me go on about just various books. We like to tailor a bespoke service, a very personal service, so we can basically get the best results. So just to confirm, you'd be interested in The Blood of Elves, yeah? Localization. Enjoy your